Well, over the past 5 days, more than 650,000 refugees have fled Ukraine since Russia launched its invasion. A team from World Vision is on its way to the border to assess the humanitarian fallout. And joining me live from Bucharest in Romania is World Vision CEO Daniel Wordsworth. Daniel, good morning to you. Thanks for your time. Just how can you help?
Good to see you, Peter. And I think greetings from snowy Romania. It's a tough time to be here. Well, there's a lot of ways we can help. As you said, there's 650,000 people already in the last 5 days have fled over the border. In Romania, it's almost 100,000. We already have our teams there. We have to meet people as they're crossing over. We're seeing mums carrying their kids over. We want to be there for them. They've been carrying their kids a long way. Someone needs to take over, help them along. So we provide shelter, clean water. We're making sure they've got hygiene kits. You know, they have to be cared for. We've actually got a team of 45 psychologists from Romania that speak Ukrainian so that they can be on the border and actually begin having these sort of tough conversations with families.
How long are you expecting to provide this help for?
Yeah, I mean, that's a really great question. And that's we're trying to plan for all contingencies. The expectation from the UN is that we'll probably see around 1 million people, refugees, by the end of the week. I think there's an expectation that we might see up to 5 million people or more becoming refugees. And the real crisis, though, will be inside Ukraine, where we might be seeing between 5 to 7 million people displaced, moving from the east into the west. But as you know, this conflict's really embroiling the entire country. And so this could really last a long time.
Yeah, and how many? I mean, we're talking 650,000 so far. That number is obviously going to increase. How many do you suspect will never go home?
Yeah, that's the question. It's really, once you cross that border, it's like crossing the Rubicon in many ways. So many refugees never get to go back home. So that's going to be one of the questions that I'm going to be asking refugee families tomorrow. How are they feeling? And I think the big question is, what will the Ukraine of tomorrow look like? Who will be ruling it? And what will life be like? But it is hard to get back, but I'm hopeful that people can return. Otherwise, their lives are truly shattered.
Do you think the Australian government is providing enough help so far, Daniel?
Yeah, I think the Australian government, like everybody, is taking a measured... maybe measured's the wrong word. We're all being just caught up in this sort of tsunami that is occurring, and we're all responding on the fly. So the Australian government's stepping up. They've committed $35 million in aid. I think we're going to see the Australian government taking more and more, being more and more committed to this, because everyone's heart's going out to this. This sort of thing shouldn't be happening. And you've got an organization like World Vision. We're here on the ground. And I think the Australian people can rally behind the Ukrainians and help. Certainly we're here. Certainly we're doing things right now.
Okay. That's Daniel Wordsworth, the World Vision CEO, speaking to us live from Bucharest in Romania. Daniel, thank you.
Good. Thank you, Peter.
My pleasure. Great work you're doing too. Thank you. We will talk to you again soon.